Okay, so I promise I will make macaroni and cheese. I'm actually not using macaroni, I'm using Rotini, and it's a healthy blend pasta. This is dedicated to El Jefe, one of my husband's friends who loves my macaroni and cheese, and also to my friend Nisa from YouTube. And I'm going to get started in just a little bit. Okay, I'm waiting for my water to boil. Okay, while I'm waiting for my water to boil for my pasta, I'm going to put three different types of cheeses in my Cuisinart food processor. Some people buy a packaged, already grated cheese to save time, but many people are unaware that they have additives that are chemicals that aren't good for our bodies. But do you, if that's what you have to do, then work it out. I'm using sharp cheese, extra sharp cheddar cheese, and Monterey Jack cheese. You can use whatever kind of cheese you want. Okay. Paper Chef baking stone to bake my macaroni and cheese. This is a 9x9 square pan, and I'm just putting a little margarine inside. You could use butter, but do you. I'm using what I have in my pantry for now. You just coat it. And then you wait, put it to the side for your macaroni and cheese. Okay, I cracked three eggs and put them in a bowl. I was going to use whipped cream, but it expired. So I'm just going to put a little milk. And I'm going to whip that. Okay. Just going to whip milk and egg together and set it to the side.
It's going to burn.
Still waiting for my water to boil. I don't know what part of the game that is. Just gonna set that to the side. I'll probably whip it more right before I add it. Okay, so I'm adding 13.25 ounces of this Rotini Healthy Harvest Whole Wheat Blend Pasta. It's a great source of fiber. You'll always have firm pasta, and it's a good way to get some extra nutrition in for your family. So I'm just going to wait for that to boil about 7 minutes. Okay, I strained my pasta and I put 1/3 of a stick of margarine in the pan. I'm trying to let it melt. I'm going to coat the pasta with the margarine. Just using my pasta stuff. My grandmom used to do this when I was little. And Aunt Martha used to work at a school for the blind down south. And she said, "What's your secret to making macaroni and cheese?" Because my grandmom didn't always bake it. She would just make kind of a creamy sauce.
You want to film this one?
Yeah.
She was just trying to make a creamy sauce in a pan, a warm pan. And that way the next day you could just heat it up with some milk. I'm not going to use all of this cheese right now because I want to sprinkle a little on top. I'm going to reserve some of it. This only. Okay, so I'm just mixing. Tina, can you get the milk, please? Mixing the cheese. Putting it all over the rotini. And I'm going to add a little milk to make it more creamy. Thank you. I'm not measuring, as you can see. I'll go by eye like a tear. Can't help it. You don't need a lot of milk. You don't want it to come to a boil because this cheese will break down. So, I want to reduce my flame power to half, like medium. And you see, it's kind of sticking. It's not quite melted all the way. You don't even need it to melt all the way. So I'm just going to transplant my cheesy sauce and pasta to my square baker, my stoneware baker. You can use whatever pan you like. And I'm just going to kind of spread it out. When you use whole grain pasta, they don't give you an entire pound, which is fine because the family will still be full. Then I'm going to take my little custardy mix, the egg, and the milk from earlier. I'm going to pour this all over the mac and cheese. That's going to make like a crispy top and a custard. And just take the rest of this cheese and put it all over the top. Now I'm going to put this in the oven on about 350 for maybe 40 minutes. Just want to make sure all that egg is cooked through. Okay, so I didn't actually bake it for 40 minutes. I think it was only about 20. And you notice it has that crispy top on there and that melted cheese. So I'm just going to take a little bit out. Mix it. Make macaroni cheese. I checked it at the 20-minute mark, and it wasn't quite done the way I wanted it to be, so put it in for 20 more minutes. And that's it. Rotini with